Hello children, in the last video you saw about matter and the characteristics of matter. Today you will learn about states of matter. States of matter means there are three forms of matter, that matter exists in three states or three forms. And how we have classified the matter into three states? On the basis of the molecular arrangement. So what are those three states? Solid, liquid and gas. A solid has a definite shape and fixed volume. A wooden block, stone, iron piece, kitchen utensil, book, pen, pencil, etc. are some examples of solids. You might have seen so many things around you which are solid, like your school bag, table, chair, your pencil box. So all these have got some particular shape and they have got some fixed volume. Volume is the space which a substance occupied. It is not so that somewhere your box occupy more space, somewhere sometimes your box occupies less space. The space which your box occupies in your bag is always the same. So the point of saying is that a solid has a definite shape and fixed volume. Now come to liquid. A liquid has a fixed volume but does not have a definite shape of its own. Water, milk, oil, mercury, cold drinks, juice, wine, etc. are some examples of liquids. Means liquids have definite volume but the shape of the liquid is not fixed. What does it mean, the shape of the liquid is not fixed? You have noticed also that if you have got many containers or vessels of different shapes and if you will pour the water in those different shape vessels or containers, the liquid will acquire the shape of that bottle. So it means it is taking the shape of the bottle. That you have seen that at home also you have got 3-4 types of bottle, and whatever the bottle you will pour the water will take the shape of that bottle. So it means that the shape of the water is getting changed. So this liquid have no definite shape of its own. Now gas, air is also a gas, so it's a mixture of gases. So various gases are present in the air but you can't see that those gases, you just feel gas. But some gases you can see also. But what about gas? A gas has neither a fixed volume nor a definite shape of its own. Neither the volume is fixed nor the shape is fixed. So this gas, it will acquire the shape of the container or wherever you will fill it, it acquires the shape of that thing. And its volume also get change, and it will not be same always, it gets change. So air, steam, nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, CNG, all these are the example of gases. Okay, so we have classified matter into three states: solid, liquid and gas. Now come characteristics of solid. First let me tell you about the molecular arrangement of solids. So these circles which I am drawing, these are the molecules. So this is the case of solid. So in solid, the molecules, can you see any space between the molecules? A very little space or there is or we can say that there is no space between the molecules of solid. So it means, and the space between the two molecules, this is the space between the two molecules, this is the space between the two molecules. The space between the two molecules, we call it as the intermolecular space. So the intermolecular space in between the molecules of the solid is negligible. Or we can say there is no space between the, or very little space between the solid molecules. So now we will look at the case of liquid. In liquid, the molecules, there in between the molecules, there is some little space. There is some little space in between the molecules. So it means the intermolecular space between the liquid molecule, this is the intermolecular space, this this is the intermolecular space, the space between the molecules. So there is a space in between the liquid molecules. So intermolecular space in liquid is more than solid. If you compare it with the solid, then the intermolecular space of liquid is more as compared to solid. Now look at the molecules of the gas. In gas, the molecules are very far away from each other. Okay, or we can say this is the molecule, this is another molecule, this is one molecule of gas, this is one. So it means that so much space is present in between the molecules of gas. So the intermolecular space is maximum. So intermolecular space is maximum in between the molecules of gases. Is it okay? Now comes intermolecular force of attraction. There is a force of attraction between the molecules. This force of attraction you call as the means the molecules, they get attracted with each other, and when they are very, that's why in case of the solid, the molecules are very close to each other because there is more attraction between the molecules. But in case of the liquid, the force of attraction is less than the solid, and in case of gas, the force of attraction between the molecule is very less. So force of attraction is maximum in case of solid, force of attraction in case of liquid is less than solid but more than gas, and in gas the force of attraction is minimum. Okay. So before reading the characteristics of solids, once we can see the molecular arrangement of solids. Here, the molecules in case of solids, they are fixed to their position. They don't change their position because The force of attraction is very strong, and the space between the two molecule is very less. So the molecules remain fixed to their position, and they vibrate or they move by remaining fixed. They can't move from this position to this. They move by remaining fixed to their position. Now, in the case of the liquid, there is a intermolecular space. There is a space between the molecules, so the molecules can change their position. This molecule can go to this side. This molecule can come here. So in this way, the point of saying is this: the molecules can change their position, or they can move. And here, in case of the solid, molecules move by remaining fixed to their position. But in case of the liquids, the molecules, they don't remain fixed to their position. They change their position. And in case of gas, what happens? In case of gas, the space is very much, so the molecules can move in any direction. That is, they change their position. Now we will read the characteristics of solids. A solid has a definite shape and distinct boundaries. That is, a solid has definite shape. Why it has got definite shape? Because the molecules remain fixed to their position due to strong intermolecular force of attraction. Sugar and salt take up the shape of the jar in which they are placed. But these are solid because the shape of the individual crystals of sugar and salts remains the fixed. If you will put sugar or salt in any jar, then what you will see that this sugar and salt take the shape of the jar. They will look, but if you will take a small crystal of sugar or a small crystal of the salt, then you will look that the shape of that small crystal or one piece of sugar, it will remains the same. It will, this shows that a solid has a definite shape. The individual crystals of sugar and salts remain fixed. So the shape of the sugar crystal or salt crystal will remains the fixed. A solid has definite volume. Means the volume of the solid will remains the fixed. It will not change. Why? Because of the fixed position of the molecules which are present in the solid. Solids do not flow. Same reason, because the force of attraction between the molecule is very high and intermolecular space is less. So, molecules remain fixed to their position. They don't flow. However, they can be heaped. Heaped means they can be, many solids can be collected and put together. Okay. But they can't flow. They will not flow like liquid or gases. Solids are rigid and cannot be compressed. Now, rigid means you can't, they are very strong, hard, and you can't compressed means you can't press them. If there is some table or chair, can you press them? And they are very rigid, very strong and very hard. So the cause for rigidity and they cannot be compressed is that the solids, this due to the strong intermolecular force of attraction. Okay. So they can't change their position, and they remain fixed to one position. They cannot be compressed or pressed easily, or they can't be compressed. Now E point. The mass of a solid having a fixed volume is usually more than for a liquid or a gas. In other words, a solid is highly dense. This statement means that if we are having three boxes are there, and in these three boxes are of equal volume. Okay, they are of equal volume, and here we put some solid thing, and here in the second box we put liquid, and in the third box we put some gas. So what happens if we will look at the number of the molecules of solid? Then we will find that the number of molecules of solid in the first box is so many, while in case of the second box, as compared to solid, the number of the molecules of liquid are less but more than gas, and in case of gas the number of molecules are very less. So the conclusion is that the number of molecules per unit volume in case of solid is very much, and in case of gas it is minimum. So density of solid is maximum and density of gas is minimum. Now F point. The constituent molecules of a solid are closely packed. It means that the intermolecular space amongst the molecules of a solid is very small, because the molecules are very close to each other in case of the solid. So the space between the molecule is very less or very very small or negligible. The intermolecular force in solids are quite strong, and the force of attraction which is present between the molecules is very high or very much. A solid may be transformed into liquid by heating it up to a high temperature known as melting point, and we can convert solid to liquid if we will heat the solid, and the solid will get convert to liquid at a temperature which we call as the melting point. So melting point is a point, or it's a temperature at which solid get converted to liquid, and the value of melting point varies from one solid to another, and every solid has its own fixed melting point. Now comes characteristics of liquids. Important characteristics of liquids are given below. A liquid has a definite volume but no shape of its own. A liquid acquires the shape of the container in which it is kept. So liquid has got definite volume. Okay. So liquid has got definite volume. Why it has got definite volume? Because in case of liquid, the intermolecular forces are strong enough to keep the molecules to confined in the liquid, but they don't have got definite shape. They acquire the shape of the container. Why? Because the molecules of liquid can change their position. Similarly, liquids can flow because the molecules can move, but they cannot be heaped. We can't put together the liquid molecules. We can't collect the liquid molecules and put them together at a place. Liquid cannot be compressed easily. We can't press the liquid very easily. However, they can be slightly compressed on applying a large compressive force. So it is not easy to compress the liquid. But if we will apply a large force large compressive force, then liquid can be compressed to certain extent. Now, liquids are dense. Means liquids are dense means the number of molecules per unit volume in case of liquid is much than gas but less than solids. The constituent molecules in liquids are less closely packed. It means that intermolecular space among the molecules of a liquid is small but somewhat greater than that for a solid. Now, in case of liquid molecules, the molecules, there is a small space between the molecules because the molecules are not very compactly packed. There is some space between the molecules of the liquid. The intermolecular force in liquid are very less strong as compared to a solid, but strong as compared to a gas. The force of attraction of liquid is less as compared to solid, but force of attraction in case of liquid is more than gas. A liquid may be transformed into gaseous state by heating up to its boiling point. On the other hand, a liquid may be transformed into its solid state by cooling it up to its freezing point. Now, we can convert liquid to gas. How we can convert? Suppose we have got water, we can change it to steam by heating it. So, we can change liquid to gas by heating up the liquid up to its boiling point. So, boiling point is the temperature at which the liquid start boiling and it will get converted to gaseous state. On the other hand, a liquid may be transformed into solid state by cooling it up to its freezing point. Or what we can do? We can have a liquid, say water, we can convert it to ice by freezing it. We can freeze that liquid so that it will get converted to solid. And the temperature at which this that liquid get converted to solid is called as the freezing point. Now comes characteristics of gases. A gas has neither a definite volume nor a shape of its own. A gas acquires the volume and shape of the container in which it is enclosed. Gas, because a gas has got no definite volume and no definite shape. Why? Because its molecules are very far away from each other, or there is a maximum intermolecular space between the gas molecules. So the molecules can move and they can acquire the shape of the container, and they acquire the shape as well as volume. Characteristics of gases. A gas has neither a definite volume nor a shape of its own. A gas acquires the volume and shape of the container in which it is enclosed. Gases have no definite shape, no definite volume. And it will take the shape and the volume of the container in which it is filled. If we will put it in a container which is very, very small, then it will occupy that much space. And if we will put it in an enclosed large container, then it will occupy that big large container space also, because of large intermolecular space in between the gas molecules. Just like liquid, gases can flow, and their flow is much faster than the flow of liquids. Gases can flow also, and their speed is much more as compared to liquid. Gases are non-rigid and can be easily compressed. Gases are not very hard or strong, and we can easily compress these gases. And gases can be compressed to a very large extent. Compressibility of gases is maximum. Gases are much lighter than solid and liquids. The weight of the gas is much lighter than solid and liquid. The constituent molecule in a gas are least closely fixed, and the molecules of the gas are not very close to each other. They are very far away from each other. It means that the intermolecular space in between the molecule of the gas is very much, or it is maximum in case of the gas. The intermolecular forces in gases are extremely weak. In fact, the magnitude of intermolecular forces in gases is almost zero, and the force of attraction which is present in between the molecules of the gas is very less, or there is no force of attraction in between the molecules of gases. So we can say that there is zero force of attraction between the molecules of gases. A gas may be transformed into liquid state by cooling it up to its condensation point, and we can convert gas to liquid state if we will cool it, and that point at which it will convert from gas to liquid we call it as the condensation point. For example, when a steam gets converted to water, that you call as the condensation point, or we can say that gas is getting converted to liquid. Now look at the activity 7. This activity shows that gases can be compressed to a large extent. There are 3 syringes, and these 3 syringes are of equal capacity. That is, the volume of 3 syringes is same. Now label these syringes as 1, 2 and 3. In the first, take out the piston of the syringes, and in each syringe at the nozzle you can put a cork, or you can close the nozzle with Fevicol. By using a Fevicol you can close the nozzle. Now take out the piston from each syringe, and then in the first syringe put chalk powder, and in the second syringe put water, and in the third syringe do not put anything. It means when there is nothing in the syringe, there is air. When the syringe is empty, then what is present? Air is present. Now here you have closed the nozzle of the syringe by a cork, or by closing the nozzle with Fevicol. Now put the piston again inside the syringe and try to push the piston. So what you have observed, then when you apply force from here to put it inside, what happened? In case where there is an empty syringe, the piston will move or get inside the syringe to a large extent. It means the gas or the air which is present in the syringe get compressed. While in the two cases where chalk powder and water present, the piston will not go inside, and the volume of the chalk powder and water remains the same. So from this, conclusion can be made that liquid and solid, they cannot be compressed by an external force, but gas can be compressed by applying external force. Now here on page number 15 there is a table 1.1. This table shows the differences between solid, liquid and gases. So you need to learn this table 1.1.